Today, I wanted to look at this cool repository that I found, actually found it on Twitter. Here's the code repository on GitHub. It's called lobe-chat. And what it is basically is an open source chatbot UI, similar to ChatGPT, but you can do stuff like save commands. You can save agents. You can save conversations. You can have a whole list of agents on your sidebar, customize the theming, customize some of the settings and stuff like that. And you can also host it on Vercel and password protect it, so you can have it online, but no one can use it unless they have the password. And there's a lot of neat plugins and features, some of which that ChatGPT doesn't have. And I wanted to show you, give you a tour and how to set it up and everything. Here you can see my personal Lobe Hub. It uses ChatGPT 4. There's 3.5, there's 4, and then there's the 4 previews. When creating a new agent, you can do something called a role prompt. That gives you some idea of how the bot should respond or the things the bot should know about. So this is a fitness bot, like I said. I wanted it to be friendly and motivational and concise, and just got a few ideas for workout plans for weightlifting. Got some healthy, high-protein meal options with ingredients and instructions. So really useful. And the benefit to using something like this as opposed to ChatGPT is we have this sidebar here where we can save conversations, we can save agents, and we can do different things like change the randomness with a little UI slider. We can set a limit on history of messages. We can do voice input here. We can use plugins. So there's a variety of plugins that you can use. There's a plugin store. So really cool stuff, really intuitive UI. You can copy and paste, you can regenerate, you can do text-to-speech. Here's a GitHub Copilot example. So here I'll ask it to show me basic CLI commands for the Astro Web Framework. So this isn't as convenient as having Copilot in VS Code running, but it is a nice looking UI and it's easy to copy and paste the code, and you can save these different topics or these different conversations on the sidebar, which is awesome. So we have the sidebar over here with the agents. There is also a discover tab where there's different agents here, and they're mostly focused on software development. You'll see there's a lot of software development stuff. Things like converting JavaScript to TypeScript would be an agent. So if I say, show me a simple JavaScript map function for an array of strings, but in TypeScript, and it will show me the TypeScript example with the string array here, the open array. And yeah, so there's cool usage for specific agents here. Master of Debating, let's try this. I like the name. So democracy is the best system for a large group of people. And it's going to tell me about how the majority imposes their will on the minority. So I have mine hosted at chatwithbots.vercel.app. It's password protected, so this does have to be tied to your open AI API key, so you can password protect it, but still have it live online, so that way people aren't using your credits. And let me show you the steps to set up your own. So here's the repository. I'll link this below. This is everything you need here. And they go, the README is really thorough, but you want to scroll down. And what you want to do is deploy with Vercel. It'll fork the repository for you and make your own deployment. You will need your OpenAI API key. You can get that from platform.openai.com. You click the API tab here. And then there's a section for API keys. So here I have one for LobeChat. And copy this value, and you will put that. It will ask you when you first set this up for the API key, before you deploy. If for some reason you get past that point somehow, your environment variables are in the settings of the Vercel project, and you will need a OpenAI_API_key, and that's where you'd place the value. If you want to password protect your chat, that is the access_code, and that you can paste in here as well. Save those values and redeploy on Vercel, and it will reload the site using those environment variables. It's cool to see the evolution of large language model software and how ChatGPT is this awesome thing, but it seems like their UI can't keep up with how great the LLM space is moving. So if you go to a ChatGPT window, it's pretty basic and bare bones, but this allows more flexibility. This allows for more history and saving different conversations and using different agents and using different plugins and chatbots. So I hope this was helpful. This was really interesting and I thought I would show it. So hopefully this helps someone out, or if it's interesting, hopefully I entertained you for the last few minutes. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.